the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters.
Good afternoon po, Father.
Today we are celebrating the feast of the Visitation of the Blessed Virgin Mary. At ngayon din po sa araw na ito, pinagdiriwang natin ang ating Misa de Gracia dito sa ating simbahan sa Basilica sa Parokya. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who, while the Blessed Virgin Mary was carrying your Son in her womb, inspired her to visit Elizabeth, grant us, we pray, that faithful to the promptings of the Spirit, we may magnify your greatness with the Virgin Mary at all times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, let love be sincere. Hate what is evil. Hold on to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Anticipate one another in showing honor. Do not grow slack in zeal. Be fervent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Endure in affliction. Persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the holy ones. Exercise hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Blessed and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoiced. Weep with those who weep. Have the same regard for one another. Do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Do not be wise in your own estimation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God indeed is my Savior. I am confident and unafraid. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and He has been my Savior. With joy you will draw water out the fountain of salvation. Give thanks to the Lord, acclaim His name. Among the nations, make known His deeds. Proclaim how exalted is His name. Sing praise to the Lord for His glorious achievement. Let this be known throughout all the earth. Shout with exultation, O city of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel.
Please stand.
Blessed are you, O Virgin Mary, who believe that what was spoken to you by the Lord will be fulfilled.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste, to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Most blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leapt for joy. Blessed are you who believed that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day, all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Pwede ho bang sabihan natin yung ating katabi? Sundan niyo ako at itong sabihin niyo, "Kapatid, ano ang kailangan mo ngayon?" Huwag niyo na pong hintayin, baka sabihin pera, jowa, asawa, shabu. Baka sabihin, "Gusto ko ng kapayapaan, huwag ka maingay dyan." Alam niyo mga kapatid, sa relationship, sa ugnayan, mahalaga yung alamin natin yung pangangailangan ng iba. Sa ating pagdiriwang ng kapistahan, ng pagbisita ni Maria, hindi lang siya basta pumunta doon. May alam din siya. Kaya nga sa ating kaalaman, ito ang magiging dahilan, magtutulak sa atin para gumawa ng kabutihan. Ang kaalaman ay hindi sapat. Knowledge is not enough. Sabi nga sa English, it is also important to know what to do with what you know. Alamin mo kung ano yung gagawin mo sa alam mo. Ito yung nakakatuwa sa panahon natin ngayon. Ang dami na nating alam sa social media. What do with what we know? Ibang mga tao, ginagamit nilang kaalaman bilang sandata. Tinatawag natin yan na weaponized knowledge. May alam ako sa'yo. Babantaan ka, tatakutin ka, iba-blackmail ka. May alam ako sa'yo. Pero ang paanyaya sa atin, gamitin natin ang kaalaman sa kabutihan. Sabi nga ni John C. Maxwell, isang inspirational author, manunulat, and speaker, ang sabi niya, "People don't care how much you know until they know how much you care." Uulitin ko po, parang play of words. People don't care how much you know until they know how much you care. Sinalin ko sa Tagalog, medyo mahirap pero pwedeng gamitin ng ganito. Ang mga tao ay walang pakialam kung ano o marami ang iyong alam hanggat hindi nila alam na ikaw ay may pakialam. Ang ibig sabihin pala niyan, ang kaalaman ay para makialam. Kaya merong positibong pakialamero. Meron ding negatibong pakialamero o pakialamera. Sasabihin niyo, "Opo, Father, may kalalakong ganyan. Katabi ko nga ngayon eh." Pakialamero, Father. Nakikialam ng jowa, nakikialam ng asawa, nakikialam ng cellphone. Pero ano yung kabutihan na ginagawa sa kaalaman? Kaya ngayong ating pagdiriwa ngayon, binanggit ko kanina, hindi basta pumunta si Maria doon sa kanyang pinsan. Itong ating binasang ebanghelyo ay karugtong ng ebanghelyo na kung saan bumisita si Anghel Gabriel at sinabihan si Maria, "Ikaw magiging ana ng Panginoon ng ating tagapagligtas." At alam mo ba? Chismis ito. Siguro parang ganoon sabi. Marites na Anghel Gabriel, ang iyong pinsan ay buntis. Kaalaman. Nalaman ni Maria. E naisip ko sa panahon natin ngayon, kung ganito nangyari, anong gagawin ni Maria? Siguro nag-text ka agad, tumawag ka agad, o nag-video ka agad. "Hello, Cass. Buntis ka pala. Imbitahan mo na lang ako pag anak, ha? Imbitahan mo na lang ako pagkabininyagan na, pag malaki na yung bata." Siguro may dahilan na tayo na hanggang doon ang gagawin, tumawag, makialam. Subalit ito yung pinakita sa atin ni Maria. She went in haste, nagmadali, quick response, sapagkat ang pag-ibig, hindi pinahihintay. Ang paglilingkod, hindi dinidelay. She went in haste. At kapansin-pansin, in person, siya mismo, hindi nagpadala ng card. So, wala naman sigurong card pa nung panahon na yon. Hindi nagpadala ng text. Walang social media. But in person, she went out in person. My dear brothers and sisters, there's no substitute to physical presence. Yung physical presence, napakahalaga niyan. Alam niyo minsan, hindi lang minsan, kadalasan, kapag ako'y nagmimisa sa patay, nakikita ko yung picture ng patay, yung nasa kabaong, yung picture lang, hawak-hawak ng asawa o ng anak, yakap-yakap pa yung picture. Nakakalungkot, kaya mong yakapin yung picture, pero yung picture, hindi makakayakap sa'yo. Hindi po ako against sa mga pumupunta ng abroad para magtrabaho, pero nakakalungkot. Hindi ka kayang yakapin ng dolyar. Hindi kang kayang yakapin ng cellphone, ng video. Pwede mong yakapin, pwede mong higaan ang pera. Pero ang pera, hindi kay kayang yakapin tulad ng pagyakap ng iyong anak, ng iyong asawa. At itong pinakita ni Maria. Go out. Reach out. Extend your hands. Kaya ang social media, maring hindi yan ang magandang mangyari at magawa natin. Lagi na lang nasa bahay. Ang daming alam, may Lindol pala. Yung sa Banban Mayor, ang dami nating alam. Anong pakialam natin? Paano tayo lumabas? Paano tayo makiisa? Paano tayo tumulong? Tulad ni Maria, mga kapatid, we need to go out in person and encounter the Lord in other people. encounter the divine in one another. The encounter of Mary and Elizabeth is the encounter of joy. And it cannot happen in just by texting, calling, social media. Kaya po assignment natin ngayon, labas-labas din ang bahay. Itong ginagawa po natin ngayon, Misa de Gracia, mahirap gawin ito nang nasa bahay lang. Kaya para sa akin, tamang-tama ang ating selebrasyon sa araw na ito. Ang Misa de Gracia ng Manawag ay Misa de Visita. We visit the place. We visit each other. We see each other. We encounter each other. Assignment po natin ito. Labas-labas din pag may time. Tulad ni Maria para sa kanyang pinsan. Sundan niyo po ako. Sundan niyo, sabihan niyo ang inyong katabi. At ito ang sabihin niyo. Kapatid, minsan lumabas ka ng bahay, tumulong sa kapwa, at lasapin ang sarap ng buhay. It is only in getting out, in reaching out, in helping people that we enjoy life. Sa mga pumunta dito, Happy Visitation Day. Sa mga may pupuntahan, I hope you, they can also tell you, salamat sa inyong pagdalaw. Please stand. Elizabeth was honored by the visit from the mother of her Lord, but Mary only wished to share her joy. As we rejoice on this feast day, let us bring our prayers to the Father who cherishes these chosen women. After his petition, we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. That the leaders of the church may teach God's people to obey God's commandments out of love and not out of fear. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may be faithful to the command to love God, and to love our neighbor. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are walking in the darkness of sin may find inspiration and courage to live up to the demands of God's commandments. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may never neglect the sick, the old, the lonely, and all who suffer in our midst. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of the devotees and pilgrims of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag, for our personal intentions, and for the intentions of this Mass. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may find eternal rest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, you put down the mighty and raise up the humble. Aided by the prayers of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we entrust our hopes to you. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
We gather today.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
May our offering of this saving sacrifice be acceptable to your Majesty, O Lord, as you were pleased to accept the charity of the most blessed Mother of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Socrates, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Dominic, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await a blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Andito na marilang tayo sa simbahan, in person. Pakitaan natin ng totoong ngiti ang ating katabi bilang tanda ng kapayapaan. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Behold Jesus, our loving Lord, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are invited to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Kahit kailan, kahit saan,
stand.
Let us pray. May your church proclaim your greatness, O God, for you have done great things for your faithful. And as Saint John the Baptist leapt with joy when he first sensed the hidden presence of Christ, so may your church rejoice to receive in this sacrament the same ever-living Lord who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Please be seated for the announcement. Sa darating na linggo, June 2, 2024, ay fiesta ng Corpus Christi. Magkakaroon ng prosesyon pagkatapos ng 4:30 p.m. Mass. Magdala po ng inyong kandila. Maraming salamat po. Please stand.
Bago po ang ating blessing, gusto ko pong pasalamatan lahat ng mga BEC, Relief Organizations, Ministries, mga katikis, ang office na tumulong para sa ating Misa de Gracia sa araw na ito. Pagkatapos ito, meron po tayong prosesyon at pupunta tayo sa Pilgrim Center para sa ating Santa Cruzan. Doon magkakaroon ng short program at awarding sa mga mananalo, sa mga prizes na ating ibibigay. Gusto ko rin pong pasalamatan ang aming pinakagwapo, pinakamabait, pinakamasipag na superior, prior ng kumbento, Father Liklik, Father Felix Legazpi III, OP. Salamat po, Father. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
We now pray for the blessing of rosaries and other religious articles and the prayer for the blessing of the sick. Let us pray. God, our Almighty Father, by your blessing, give us strength and support in our frailty. Turn with kindness toward our sick brothers and sisters. Free them from all illness and restore them to good health through the intercession of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag, so that in the sure knowledge of your goodness, they will gratefully bless your holy name. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
In memory of the mysteries of the life, death, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, and to the honor and glory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag, may these rosaries, images, candles, oil, and other religious articles be blessed and made holy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.